Hola, senores and senoritas, it's Brad, back again with another Cortex video. I say senores and senoritas, there's no women watching this. I've seen the stats, I know the analytics. Ladies, I don't know why, but hey, it's, you know, we're open. We can, this is a safe community, the Cortex community. Feel free to like, subscribe, create your own videos, please comment and that kind of stuff. I know you play guitar, I've seen you play, you're on my TikTok all the time. There's plenty of female guitarists out there, and I imagine someone has a quad cortex, and we'd love to talk. Anyway, I want to say thanks to everybody that's already watched my video. I'm up in like the thousands now, which is crazy, considering I just plugged in and played. So it's been unreal. Thanks for all the likes, all the comments, subscribers, everything. It's been really cool, considering I just put together a video which took like 20 minutes to put together. This video is actually going to be in response to a question brought forward by a user called Pekka Laaksonen 8384. I'm sorry if that's actually pronounced incorrectly. I imagine you're Scandinavian, I am not, so I apologize, but I will put a, yeah, there'll be the question on the screen somewhere, and basically the question was, how can you put a rig or a band set up together through the quad cortex? And so that's what I've got here. I go through the basic setup, but I have three guitars here. I actually responded saying in my next band rehearsal we're gonna do it. But I figured I'm on YouTube and I'm playing guitar, and if there's anything that I've learned from watching YouTube guitarists, we're just failed band musicians. Yeah. Some people would say with the correct application of lubrication, anything is possible. But actually, if you have a quad cortex and a couple of guitars and a laptop, then yeah, you can create a band. So that's what I've done. I don't have a bass. I will be getting one, but I don't have one right now. So there's going to be no bass in this, but there are three guitars. One is one that's strapped to me. I have a Les Paul Studio, and I also have an acoustic guitar, and they're all plugged into the quad cortex and they're going out of several outputs. So I'm going to grab the camera and I'm going to show you around the rig and show you the quad cortex. And I'm going to show you the different sounds, and I'll put together a little recording. I heard a song on the radio and I was like, that's going to be perfect for this, because I hear three sort of distinct guitar layers. We have an acoustic guitar, we have a slightly cleaner guitar, and we have an overdriven guitar. The song I actually heard was Tom Petty's Running Down a Dream, and I figured, well, I think the quad cortex can do that, so let's get cracking with the video. Hey, so I think on my last video I was using my GoPro. It's an old GoPro, and for some reason it's now not working, so I'm just using my phone, and what I'm going to do is talk you through the rig now. So I have three guitars plugged into the quad cortex. This is the first one here. This is a Core Silver Sky from 2020, a fantastic guitar. The second guitar is my Les Paul Studio, and the third guitar is my Electro Acoustic by Seagull. If you wanted to know, yeah, that's my roommate's cat, Buck. Maybe we'll get some more female viewers with him now. I don't know. Anyway, it's the internet. Who doesn't like cats? So, the actual chains, basically we have the Silver Sky. That's the cable going straight over to the quad cortex over here. And then this white cable, which is plugged out of the send, is going over to my Marshall, which is plugged in. It's going into the effects loop. And so it'll just come out of the cab. The sound of the cab, and it's using the power amp. So the actual line is here. I'm using in two, so it's actually this cable right here that the Silver Sky is running into, and as I said, it's going out of the send, and you can see that it says send 1-2 here, and over here it says in two, so that's the Silver Sky chain. The top chain is the Les Paul Studio, so that's going following the cable. Again, this is going into in one, just like it says on the top here. It's running through a little amp and a cab, and then it's going on the out 1-2. So if we follow the out 1-2, which is the XLR, it's going to my little head rush speaker, the FR-FR-108. And then thirdly, we have my electroacoustic. Electroacoustic is going in return. So the quad cortex having the dual effects loops has two send and returns. We have the acoustic going into return one. just like it says on the chain here. I have a little EQ thing, and then it's going to go out to USB 3. So USB 3 is plugged into my laptop, into GarageBand, and then I have little speakers in my headphone output, and so it's got those, that sound coming out of GarageBand is going into these two tiny little speakers here. So turning up the quad cortex, if I now strum the acoustic, there's sounds coming out of the speakers here. I can turn that up a little bit more. And there's the sound coming out of there. It's a bit of a buzz. This guitar. That's coming out of there. And then if I strum this guitar, that's coming out of there. I hope that's nice and clear. Before I actually showed the recording that I put together using the quad cortex and the three separate guitars, you may have noticed that there was none of these were mic'd up. So what I'm actually going to do, hopefully you've heard the outputs through the quad cortex, but to actually record this, I'm going to record using the USB outputs on the quad cortex. So they'll be in various different USB outputs because the quad cortex has that capability. And then each one of those will have its own separate channel running through GarageBand, where I'm just going to loop some drums, play over the top, and kind of put the song together. So I just finished up recording that part. It's not going to be a nice one. I'm not mastering it or anything like that. But you just heard it playing over the background of the video of me actually just performing it. So I know what you're all thinking. Like, does he have guitar stands? No, he does not. Well, he did, but some of them broke. So they're all sitting precariously here. But actually, I'm sure you're more focused on the quad cortex. So I did change the outputs, like I said. Previously, these were going to different speakers and that, like I said, right at the start of the video. However, I just changed them all to, USB 3, USB 4, USB 5. I did have to put in a cab because to just make it sound a little better. This was for the Silver Skyline. My acoustic, I did have to turn up a little bit. So if I actually just tap on the setting here, not tap, but press and hold, you can see the output is like right at the top there. That was just to get it recording, the volume to come through on the recording. I didn't have to do anything to the line for the Les Paul. And so what we have here is my GarageBand screen, and you can see I literally just put in the lines acoustic, Les Paul, Silver Sky, and then I just grabbed this retro rock drum fill, these are the little lines that were recorded. All done in sort of one take, really. Figured what I should do as well is just go through each line and just, you can see here the input, it says quad 3 on the Les Paul, it says quad 4, and then on the Silver Sky it says quad 5, and those are just the inputs from the screen on the quad cortex, so that's how you can get them all to line up. The song itself, like I said, it is a very poor copy of Tom Petty's Running Down a Dream. So I'll just call it Jogging Up a Nightmare. There you go. Okay, so thanks for the watching. Hopefully that's answered your question. I'd like to obviously try it with bass and that kind of stuff. But yeah, I not only can I even play live, just like I was saying, out of the speakers and cabinets and different outputs that we have, but also recording. I just recorded everything through the quad cortex there, just using very simple settings, very quickly put together. It's something really quick and easy to do. Hope that answers your question. And I hope anybody else is watching and is thinking like, oh yeah, I've heard that the quad cortex can do stuff with a full band. Well, here's the proof. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them down in the comment box below. Don't forget to like and subscribe. I really appreciate all the feedback that you guys are giving me. Just even watching the video, it's fantastic. Like, yeah, unreal. Thank you so much. I hope to keep you guys entertained. If not, see you next time.